Hopefully working for the FBI. I was going into school, double majoring in criminal justice and psychology. And I think I try to go in to be a police officer and then hopefully become a detective or something. Just like I like the forensic stuff, like the mystery type deal. You gotta, you know, track the case and do everything involved in that. I think it's pretty cool. Play a lot of golf. I'm all right. Play 5-10 handicap. One time I threw my club and I ended up losing it. Threw it into like that tall grass and I ended up losing it. Couldn't find it. So I just gave up. Put my hat on with two outs. I take it off when I get in the dugout, and then as soon as there's two outs, I put my hat on. And that's, I don't know, it's something I've been doing for a while. I think I did it, I started doing it in college. I sat there and wait, and then two outs, I just put my hat on. I wouldn't put on a one out or, you know, anything like that. Just with two outs, I put it on. It's worked so far, yeah.
No, I'd probably try to be acting somewhere. see how good I do at that. But yeah, probably acting or something with music, maybe. I like music a lot, so I like to drive and listen to music. But let's say video games. Maybe. I like Splinter Cell. Yep, got a little strategy involved in it. Not really. Everybody calls me Carter or you. Other than that. I know. Other than that, it's been pretty much. They mess up my name so much. It's kind of like a nickname. Luckily, I get to sit by myself since I'm a catcher. I gotta let my legs breathe a little bit. But the worst guy, I don't know. I really don't know. I would have to say a guy who stays up all the time, and I'm usually that guy. So.
Everybody calls me emo. You know, I've been emo for about 25 years, and sometimes I don't even remember my first name. People will call me Scott, I'll walk right by them until they drop an emo, and then I'll realize they were talking to me. Well, I'd probably be running a golf course. My brother and my dad both were golf course superintendents, so they would probably show me the way to get this field green and run a golf course. I'm not a golfer. I'm a hacker. I play a little bit of hack ball, get up there and just hit it as far as I can. And when I slice it to the right, I go hit it again. I can't say that I really had a lot of embarrassing moments, but I think like every time I have to make a trip to the mound, before I hit the warning track, I tell myself don't trip and make sure my fly's up. So far, so good.
I think I'll probably be an athletic trainer of some sort. You know, I kind of like the physical, you know, things of playing sports, whether it's football, baseball, basketball, you know, so. I like seeing people get better and stronger, so that's probably what I'll be doing. I like making music. You know, I have a keyboard and stuff like that, so I like making beats, my own music. I like starting, you know, something from nothing, you know, and making it sound good. So, I mean, I know some people where, you know, I wanted to get a little serious into it, I could, but right now it's just a hobby. I just like having fun with it. Yeah, I try not to have any, but, you know, I always gotta have my glove in a certain spot, my bat's in a certain spot in the dugout and stuff like that. If not, I kind of feel like it doesn't have the kind of power it should, you know, but I try to stay away from the superstitions because things always change and stuff like that. I got one. It's probably when I tried to rob a ball in college and I jumped up, my glove fell over the fence and I had to jump over and get the glove, so that's probably pretty embarrassing.
I grew up in Jersey and then I went to high school in
in Dallas, and I went to Los Angeles really because of the warm weather in the winter, so I could do all sorts of stuff outside training. And then also, I can't lie, I went for the social scene, man. It's got a famous social scene, and I wanted to experience that in a time when I didn't have a lot else going on. So for anybody that's ever been there and spent some time there, I mean, you really do see famous people all the time, everywhere you go. And after you're there for a while, it's really not even that impressive anymore. It's just, you get used to it. I try to go out, try to be as social as possible, and I'll really do anything to be social during the off season. I'll go and enroll in a dance class to meet pretty girls. I'll go to yoga. To me, it does not matter. If it's a social environment and there's a chance that I can meet some pretty girls, I'll be there.
I got a little routine, like go from the cage, get dressed, do all that every day. Same routine. So I don't think I have to do it to be have a good day. It's just something that it's a habit and it's a daily activity. But I'm sure I get into little games of ping pong around it now and then that throw my pregame routine off. So I was a big fan of Looney Tunes. I wasn't really into comic books or anything like that. So anything on Saturday morning, Flintstones, Scooby Doo, anything like that. I played high school basketball and our JV uniforms weren't exactly up to standards, and we had to tape our shorts, and I was on a breakaway and I went up to lay up, my shorts were falling down, so I had to grab them and lay it up. I scored the basket, so I saved myself a lot of humiliation. When I got called up, it was pretty amazing. I mean, it was awesome. It's everything you dreamed of. It's what you wanted to do when you were little, and I got to do it. And I mean, and then the year after that, I got designated. It kind of went from being on a high to what the heck's going on, you know? But trying to work back up there, I'm doing pretty well here, so hopefully something will happen soon. I still got a year left of school to finish up. It was somewhere in finance, that's what I was majoring in, so I have to be somewhere with that. I mean, something with numbers, that's really all I can handle. So I like the idea of not being stuck in an office. You know, I'd be probably something where, you know, you can have meetings on a golf course or do something like that where you're not just stuck sitting down for 8 hours a day. Probably when I got drafted. I mean, that was something that when I was growing up, you always dream about, but you never really think it's going to happen until you heard your name called. Well, I probably had a lot of embarrassing moments where they kind of run together, but probably the one that sticks out of my head was when I was freshman year, playing outfield, never really played. Kind of one of the first days I played out there, we were playing Fullerton, which is like our arch rival with everybody, you know, huge games, opening night, Friday night, and I'm out there, it was like the 10th, 11th inning, something like that. Ball gets hit out there, I went back, it's kind of wet, just slipped, fell down, guy gets on second base, we lose the game, just, that was probably the worst I've felt.
I grew up in a big family. We all played. I have six brothers. We always played football and baseball, and I think football is my second love. And so if I could stay free from injuries, because I tend to be beat up every now and then, I'd love to play football. I'm the second youngest of six, and 24, so we're all about 2 years apart. I mean, obviously, when you're younger, you know, they picked on me a little bit, but it made me a little tough. But it was fun. You know, like I said, we're all very close, and you know, the times I do get to go home and see him, you know, all we do is hang out with each other because we're each other's best friend. I mean, I guess you could say Superman, maybe, because when I was younger, I always dreamed that I wish I could fly, and that was always a sweet thing, but obviously, as you get older, you realize that's not possible. From what I wear to the field to how I put my socks on every day, I mean, just this bracelet right here is a superstition. I haven't been only wearing it for a couple weeks. I think pretty much since I've been here or since I've been back here milling, and I've been doing all right, so I'm gonna keep wearing it. And maybe if I go in the funk, I'll take it off.
Probably be coaching baseball.
Baseball is really all I've ever known, so I'd have to be doing something involving the game. Man, I'd love to be on the PGA Tour. I think that's a pretty good lifestyle. I'm an average golfer. Depends on the day. I've always, you know, I've got my weaknesses, but I'd say I can hang with just about anybody in the clubhouse. Probably in college, I was warming up down in the bullpen and noticed that a foul ball was coming my way on the ground. So I walked down the mound, tried to pick it up, popped up, hit me right in the face, knocked my hat off. The whole crowd was watching. They all enjoyed it. I was kind of embarrassed about that. Man, favorite superhero would probably be Inspector Gadget.
Interesting.
He had some pretty wicked tools, so I kind of liked him. I didn't really ever buy into Superman or Batman or any of that kind of stuff, so.